Hi, today I will use Blender, which is an open source tool, and so that means you can read the source code, sorry, and it's free also, so you don't have to buy it. And this program permits to model real stuff with real geometry. So here you can see that I did model two spheres, one big and one very small. And you can see that I can rotate them as I want. Okay, and I can change the use of perspective or not. And you can recognize in which mode I am, simply because when you have a perspective, all the lines tend to meet to one point. So these lines are parallel, but they don't appear like, but they are. And they will meet somewhere in the infinite plane. These are also meeting somewhere on the left. And yeah, if you took the diagonals, you would see that they meet somewhere there. So you can see that there is some special points that appear. When you are in the orthographic mode, parallels keeps being parallel. So here we have parallels. And they are all parallels, these are parallels. So that's the difference between the two modes. And of course, it changed the how you see the scene. So if I do that, you can see that that one became closer, it appears closer. And if I use perspective, it appears that it's further away, but it's just the way it's represented. Voilà. You can also see that the spheres change a bit. So this is due to the way it's projected. That's not the same geometry. So you can see a bit more here because that would be hidden by perspective. So that's kind of stuff. Okay, all of this just to show something very simple. So normally you should be you should agree that this one is smaller than this one. If you don't, then maybe you have to review like the stuff you get at school when you are six and even before. I believe Piaget says it's age 3. So if you can't see the difference in size, then you have a big problem. But it can be learned. Okay, so. Let's do this. Let's click that. And here you see I'm in the orthographic mode, so lines are parallel. I click this button to face the to get the two allez, the two spheres aligned. And now by scrolling my mouse or using this button, I can zoom and it will just put me closer to the object, so I can get in the object and go back. Okay, so this is the orthographic mode. There is no surprise because there is no allez, there is no allez, perspective, so it's simply zooming in and nothing surprising. Now I will enable perspective and it will change a lot. So now I did change to use perspective and my position matter. So as you can see, the small sphere did grow because I'm closer. If I go further, it will shrink, and if I go closer, it will simply grow. And as you can see, at some point, the small sphere would appear the same size as the big one. And the interesting part is that they will both line up. As you can see, you can't tell the difference between the two once I overlap them. And this is due to theorem of Thales. Because what happens is that if two objects have adequate sizes, you can't say, tell if they are far away or close to you, because they can be big but far, or small and close. And this is what you are seeing here. So what that means is that if you get pictures, like if I take a picture of this, you can't simply put it there and by stretching it, because you need to know the distance to scale properly the picture. So you need two informations, that the distance from you to the distance from the thing that took the picture, and the distance for the other picture, the same stuff. So you need two distance, and this is what will tell you how to scale it. But you can't simply map the curve, because if I do that, I do map the curve, and you can say, ah, this one, this continent is the same as the one behind. But that's not true. This one is much, much, much smaller, so that's stupid. And here it's very visible. And that curvature match perfectly. These are two circles, so easy to match. And there is not much to say. Okay, it did bug. The experiment show clearly that you can't do that. Okay, let's zoom. So you can try it by yourself, because it's not complicated to get it working. Just two spheres. Even two blank spheres will do. I just put hearts on this, just so there is something to see. But yeah, you will see that it will match perfectly, because yeah, that's how perspective work. And if you put in orthographic mode, then you won't have this phenomenon, because that's allez, that's how it works without perspective. Everything being parallel, getting closer is just growing everything at the same rate. When you are in perspective, you have something called parallax, so stuff tend to grow faster the closer you get to them. And as you can see, if I double the size of the small one, then the one behind didn't even grow twice the size. And if I go close enough, the one in front will cover the one behind. So that means that the one in front is growing far quicker than the one behind. So that's the parallax stuff. So all of this tells you that you can't match a curve and get it done. It's just nonsense. You need to have the two di distance, and by distance I mean the distance between me and that stuff, and the distance between me and that stuff, and then I can do the scaling. So here I would say, okay, if I take this as a indicator, I'll just put it somewhere here. So if I was there when I took the picture of this, then to scale this appropriately, I would have to make it like multiply this radius by the distance from there to there, divided by the distance from there to there. That will give me a ratio that I would have to apply to this radius, and then I would know if the two are equals in size. And if we do this, then we would see that it is not. So obviously, because it would be, even if I scale it by three times, So I did type S3. That it's not even there yet. And if I do it maybe 30 time, yeah, it's a bit. So as you can see, we'll put 20. Okay, I will put 15. No, 18. Okay, 18 seems about right. And I can check this with the orthographic mode. Yeah, so it's around 20 times, but there is now 20 times the distance, and you can see that even the. So, yeah, voilà, that's. So, if that last part did confuse you, just forget it. It's the Thales theorem, and you can maybe have an overview of it on Wikipedia. But yeah, that's not so much to say. So I hope you did understand with this simple video and this demonstration. And voilà, thank you for watching.